Hey guys, welcome to another episode of State of the Build here on the Peak Auto YouTube channel. I'm Emily Reeves, your grateful host. I love doing this series. And most of the people that I have on this series, I already know. This person, our guest today, is a person that I've never met. I've never talked to him, but I'm really excited to meet him and get the scoop. Our guest today is Thad from Petty's Garage. Now, he's not just a random person. He is Richard Petty's grandson, and he is going to be taking us around Petty's Garage, their whole shop, not the museum, but their shop where they build customer cars. So you can have Petty's Garage build you a custom whatever, and they do incredible work. I actually got to tour that facility 1 year on power tour, and they were actually just telling me that this year they're gonna have like a barbecue, like a really laid back, open the doors to the garage and let people come walk around if you're on power tour this year. So keep that in mind. But yeah, let's shoot Thad a text and get this kicked off. What's going on, Thad? Thank you so much for taking the time to toss videos back and forth with me. I'm so excited for everybody to see Petty's Garage. I had a blast when I got my tour of that spot, and you guys do some incredible work. So let's start wherever you want to start. And we can also like be scoping out projects behind you, and I'll be like, oh, I want to see more of that one. Or like, is that a Viper? Like, just show us what you got, and then we can delve into a few of the projects you guys are working on as you give us a tour. How's that sound?
Sounds great, Emily. So I'm excited to give you guys a video tour of Petty's Garage. Right behind me here, this car's going to Goodwood. So Grandpa raced this car. And this is the 2 plus 2. It's actually his least favorite race car, according to him. But he raced this thing, so we'll go to the Goodwood Festival and go up the hill over there. And then we have the Viper over here that we're finishing up. So we've done a lot to this car. We can dive into it if you guys wanted to. But we're finishing this one up. And then we got our Challengers. We get a lot of Mopar stuff here. So our Challenger here, we're getting something pretty cool we do. We just put this cool cover on out of the car. Here's the other side. It's custom, everything. So obviously pretty cool stuff. Richard Petty signed right there. That's always a plus. And then the exhaust tube on this one. We seem to get a lot of type of work like that, you know, here. So we do a lot of head and cam stuff on the 426s and the Mopar stuff, and then just jewelry for under the hood, like the cool covers there. So yeah,
it's sure enough a working shop. I hear people working in the background. That's awesome. So the Viper on the lift, I really like Vipers. Do you guys do like a lot of like internal engine mods to customer cars, or are most of them like tunes and just like bolt-ons, heads and cam swap stuff? I'm sure it's a lot of turnaround there. That's so cool.
Yeah, Emily, so we don't just do basic tunes here. As you can see, this is our motor room or engine shop or whatever you want to call it. We do a lot of the 426 stuff. We do a lot of Hemi stuff up here. And this is actually where they used to build the engines for the race cars, right here in this room and the room beside it. So as you can see, we have on their stands a lot of just bare block Hemi stuff. Here we have three of them that you can see right now. We actually do these, and people are putting them in Jeeps. So we work with Ruby Trucks, and they're putting them in the Jeeps. And then down here, we do a lot of the restoration stuff. So this is kind of a good view of what we do here. So we have our race car right here that was raced in 91 at Sonoma. And it became a show car, and then a customer ended up with it, and he brought it back to us, and he wants it race ready. So he's gonna take it on a couple of road courses. So we've got it stripped completely down right now. We put a new nose back on it, getting it back to the way it was raced. And then over here we have the El Camino. That was a frame off restoration. It's just absolutely beautiful. The body for it over there is a black cherry color beside it. So, and then street cars, we do a lot of restoration on those kind of builds too. So anything you want. So as far as the Viper goes, it actually got a brand new V10 engine here with the twin turbos on it. This carbon fiber hood was put on here. And then brand new transmission and rear end, the T56. And so everything was done here. Everything was built here in the engine shop, just around the corner. So Fred, our engine builder that used to build the race car engines, built this thing and we put it in. And then we've done the turbos on it 2 times. So yeah, pretty sweet stuff here. We can lift it up and look at the transmission and the underneath stuff. So we're finishing up installing the dual oil pumps here on the underneath, somewhere over there on the table, and then our new T56 transmission, and then the custom drive shaft from the drive shaft shop, the one piece, really completely custom short drive shaft, and then brand new rear end, great looking, still see all the grease is still red, so hasn't even been moved around a whole lot yet, but yep, everything underneath, brand new.
Dude, that Viper is sick. Twin turbo, I'm sure like everything internally in that engine is built for holding all that boost. Oh my gosh, and a T56, I'm a big fan. Got one in my favorite car behind me. That's rad. Man, that car is stellar. That hood, are they gonna paint the hood to match the car, I wonder, or leave it carbon fiber raw? Ooh, so amazing. Okay, so then the engine room is incredible. Then we walk into where the full restos are happening, and that El Camino looks incredible. Let's go over that build. That looks pretty amazing. Total frame off, like an incredible, was that a factory chassis or was that a modified chassis? Give me the rundown on that build.
Yeah, we can dive into the El Camino, and for that, I've got the guy who did the most work on it, Brian Witcher.
I didn't do the most work, but I did a fair amount on it. 1970 El Camino Pro Street. It's got an Art Morrison chassis, powder coated, all the suspensions powder coated. A UC 555 big block Chevrolet with a trim of T56 Magnum sitting behind it. We custom made all the exhausts here, had it ceramic coated per the customer's request. He wanted headers all the way back to the tailpipes coated, so we did that. Stainless brake lines, stainless fuel line, custom made for it. Yeah, it's just kind of a cool car, truck, whatever you want to call it. But you know, it's got pretty big meats on the back of it. The customer, one cool thing about it, a lot of the fabrication work went into the bed of this truck. The customer wanted all the ribs to continue on the tubs. He didn't want just a set of tubs on it like most people tub one. So we had all those ribs made. They're all rosetted in, and all body worked in now. So it's all kind of cool. Really can't wait to see it come together. We're really, really close to marrying the two together. So, you know, pretty much this build, everything on it was customer request. The wheels, tires, you know, down to the color of the brake calipers. They look black on the video, but they're actually black cherry, like the body. You see it when you get in the sunlight. So really cool build.
Man, y'all are really just making people's dreams come true. Thank you so much for the rundown, Brian. That was so cool. That car is gonna be so amazing. Those big wide tires and mini tub like that with the custom mini tub, that was really gorgeous. I love metalwork like that that's unique and one-off. That's gonna be a beautiful car. Oh my goodness, is that thing gonna be on power tour, I wonder? Or maybe people will look at it when they tour the shop on power tour. Oh man, so cool. Okay, well Thad, you want to take us through maybe one more build before we wrap this up? I cannot wait to see more cool stuff coming out of that shop. I know you guys have a million amazing projects, but maybe show us one more.
So here we are now with the original Petty's Garage Challenger, and the owner of the car, Greg Stedman, is going to tell you a little bit about it.
Yeah, Thad, this is the original car we bought in 2010. It was our test mule, all the products we built on the original RPSS, Richard Petty Signature Series cars. So It was the first supercharged engines for the Challengers, custom shaker hood that we've made to fit that. This car has a lot of our suspension parts on it. We did a Sand Hills Open Road Challenge. It's got a roll cage in it. Pretty big tires for a Challenger without the wide body. 315, 30, 19s all the way around it. So we do a lot of autocross and track days with it.
So now we're going to look underneath this thing. I see a lot of painted blue. Tell me what's going on here, Greg.
Yeah, there's a lot of scuff marks. Like I said, we do a lot of track days and autocross with it. But you can see all the petty blue parts, signature color for us, the aftermarket subframe, K-frame sway bars, transmission cross members, just a lot of chassis parts to some of the stuff to lighten the car, some of the stuff to just stiffen up certain parts of it, and better bushings and control arms in it. You can see the, looks like it's a test car for us, so we just do a lot of different things with it, develop new parts just like we do for the Camaros and the Mustangs.
Y'all are so awesome. Thank you so much, Greg, for the rundown on that car. It's really cool to see kind of the R&D platform, one of the platforms that you guys develop parts for. That's so neat. Man, thank y'all so much. This was really, really cool to see some behind the scenes projects there, and then just like what a huge operation y'all have going on. I hope any folks that are on Power Tour this year get to stop by the shop and see it in person and see some of those builds as they continue to unfold. So cool. Thad, thank you so much. And from what I understand, you're kind of a badass race car driver, so I wish you much luck on your upcoming race. And I hope to have you guys back on the series sometime to look into more builds as y'all continue to build awesome cars in the shop. Petty's Garage is amazing. Thank y'all so much. Huge props to your grandfather for building such an incredible, legendary business, but also brand. So it's amazing. Y'all are so cool, man. Thank you so much for taking the time, and hope y'all have an awesome afternoon.
Yeah, Emily, thank you so much for having us on and letting us show you a little bit of what we're about here at Petty's Garage. It is a really cool operation, and it all started in 1949 from a couple of guys who wanted to go racing. So it's really cool to see what it's become, and for me to be able to be part of it, it is really, really special to me. So would love for everybody who's on the Power Tour, when they do a stop nearby, to of course come by. I think we're going to do a little cookout here, so whatever, everybody is welcome to come while you're on the Hot Rod Power Tour. Again, thanks for having us on and letting us show you a little bit of what Petty's Garage is about.
Massive thanks to Thad for making the time to make this episode with me today. I hope you guys enjoyed the tour of Petty's Garage. What an amazing establishment, and to have that family tie is really beautiful too. Please leave your comments below and tell us who else you would like to see on this series. Thank you guys so much. Thanks for subscribing and liking, and we'll see y'all on the next episode.